Serious talk with me.
I would never lie to you.
Why would you lie to me?
I would never.
You're doing it right now. Come on. Serious. Why would you lie to me like this?
I would never.
Lainey, quit lying to me.
I would never.
Lainey, relationships aren't built off lies. Are you gonna stop lying to me?
I'm not.
Why do you keep lying? Why do you keep on lying to me? Lainey, I don't. This is. It's very unhealthy to keep lying. What'd she make? Burgers?
What?
What'd she make? Burgers? Burgers?
Hamburger helper!
Oh. Ewy.
Well, you see, I grew up on the stuff because it was a dollar a box, and that's all we could afford, so... I'm pretty okay with it. And I haven't had it before.
We did, didn't we?
I don't see one. The only one I see is a fish that I find by using the fucking fish.
I'm not sure.
Didn't we get a dolphin in there?
I think we did, but it might have despawned. We didn't name them, so I think we call it something.
Do we have a name for it?
We should. Somewhere. I mean, we can always fish for them.
You can fish for a dolphin?
I love you, beautiful. I meant name tag. It doesn't?
Yeah.
you'd be a lot more likely to catch a dolphin than a name tag. Yeah. No, you're right.
Oh, I thought you were like,
No, 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 they actually do.
I wish you could catch a dolphin in a bucket. That would be lit.
That would.
Come here, let me catch you in a bucket. Hey. Kitty, it didn't work.
Really?
Yeah.
Who would have guessed? Then why did you try it? Okay, whatever floats beautiful's boat. My level of laziness in a nutshell. Oh, I got a tripwire hook.
These things are so annoying. Like, why?
Are you okay?
I just wanna know why.
Okay. What did I say? I got an info. You can get the dolphin on the team on fishing. Or, okay, we can both get the dolphin. Okay. What do we want to name him first? Dolphin. Do you want to? Neptune. There you go. Neptune.
Ow.
Name's Neptune. Okay. Pillagers everywhere.
Can we help you?
They're dead. Just sprint, just swim away. Oh, I used a lead to get them.
Yeah.
We should probably get a lead later.
I have one.
Oh.
I've been chasing them around the whole time trying to go or trying to get them. But I can't. Well,
yeah.
Oh,
go. This way. Okay, let's do it in the morning.
Oh, no, I didn't. Come on, dolphin. Come on, little dolphin. I promise you'll like it in the aquarium. I promise. I just pull him out?
Yep. Now you broke it. Oh crap, the game's on. Dead by Daylight. You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. It's a harpoon gun. Right?
Wait, does he have it?
Yeah.
Did you
read it? No.
Do you
want to
read it?
You can see that. Don't want to play so hard. This is because when people are like a far distance from you, you can just shoot them, hold them in. The whole point of the game is the survivors can get a distance killer. But if you just pulls them straight back in, he gets it. This guy's a bunch of folks. Dang, poor David. Oh, jeez, poor David. You have to see that. That poor guy. Last person I hit to the to be a nice person, and then they just run away from you. Story. Okay. Born in the dust-ridden badlands of the American Midwest, Caleb Quinn was son to struggling Irish immigrants. On the edge of the frontier, sickness, famine, and death were common sights, and pioneers contended for whatever scraps they could claim while tycoons feasted. Caleb's father, once an engineer, had few options to ply his trade, as businesses posted a common sign, "No Irish need apply." His antiquated tools laid untouched for years until Caleb uncovered them. Noticing his son's interest in the trade, he gifted him his old wrench. The device Caleb made under his father's guidance had quaint applications, but when his father was away, they took a grim turn. He hid plans for a mask that would gouge barbed needles into human eyes and rip them from their sockets, complete with sketches of it fitted on boys who bullied him. With age, Caleb's engineering abilities became marketable, and employers put their discrimination aside. Henry Bayshore, the owner of United States West Rail, United West Rail and hired him. Caleb first invented the gun that shot railroad spikes into the ground. Next, he made a steam-powered tunneling drill, but as Bayshore feigned indifference, the devices began turning up at other companies, the patents stolen from Caleb and sold. A familiar sensation coursed through Caleb's blood, feeding the sharp pain in his heart. Rage overwhelming him, he burst into Bayshore's office and smashed his face into a bloody stew. As he was pulled away, he pushed his specialized gun to his boss's gut, squeezed the trigger, a railroad spike plowed through skin and viscera, nailing Bayshore to his desk. The only thing that saved Caleb from hanging was Bayshore's unlikely survival. For 15 years, Caleb was confined to Hellshire Penitentiary, the nation's first private prison. In a fortress of illiterate convicts, he found an unlikely friend in the educated prison warden. He designed torture devices for him, and in return received extra meals. After a time, the warden offered to commute his sentence. He spoke of something greater than monetary wealth, political capital, and that his connections could have Bayshore framed and rotting behind bars for life. He had only one request: make him rich, fill the prison. Remember when I couldn't find my toothbrush in the morning? That's where it was. Yeah. I forgot to grab it again. Thank you. Where are you getting those granola bars from? I barely had any. He had only one request: make him rich, fill the prison, use ingenuity to bring outlaws in alive. Caleb returned to his workshop. With a few modifications, he emerged with something new: the spear gun. The first trial occurred when a thief robbed a Chinese laundry. Seizing on the opportunity, Caleb unleashed his prototype. Metal joints screeched as the spike shot forward, gouging into the target's abdomen, but as the spear tugged it, caught the thief's intestines. With an ungodly sound, yanked them on the dusty road. After several iterations, the disembowelments dwindled, but Caleb had already earned his new name, the Death Slinger. Looking to protect his asset, the prison warden pulled strings and released Irish immigrant inmates to form Caleb's posse. The Hellshire Gang was born. For 6 years, they roamed the country collecting wanted outlaws for the prison, fulfilling their end of the bargain. After a bloody battle at Glenvale, Caleb caught notice of a newspaper headline: Henry Bayshore purchases Hellshire Penitentiary. In the picture, a disfigured Bayshore proudly shook the warden's hand. Caleb's heart pounded with rage, blood swelling as if it would burst from his veins. He'd been sold out, a pawn in a rich man's game. The Hellshire Gang pledged their loyalty to Caleb and called for the warden's head. In the thundering gallop, they smashed through the prison entrance, shrieking like bloodthirsty marauders. A guard raised his pistol but hesitated. A spear punctured his chest. Caleb grabbed the man's head and slammed it against the prison cell until it spilled through the bars. Reaching the warden's office, Caleb kicked the door and was met with a fortunate sight. It wasn't only the prison warden who cowered in the corner, but Henry Bayshore. Overpowered with rage, Caleb rushed Bayshore, beating, bludgeoning, and tearing at his flesh. The man's blood dripped from his face, crimson pooling at his feet. The Hellshire Gang swarmed the warden, snapping bones with each kick. With the two men broken and begging for death, the posse dragged them to the commons where they were left to the growing crowd of prisoners. Soaked in blood and sweat, Caleb hobbled to his old cell, hardly paying notice to Bayshore's screams. He sat on the bed's edge as drops of blood ran from his fingertips. A thick, unnatural fog streamed through the barred window. He pulled out his old wrench, cracked and rusted, and ran a thumb along the metal, regarding it with faded eyes. He couldn't remember when it came into his possession. He didn't care to remember. At his feet, he saw a dusty path, and at its end, silhouettes of all who had done him wrong. The boys who bullied him, the executives who took advantage of him, and again, Henry Bayshore. Emerging from a fog were the tools to dispose of them. Unforgiving steel hooks, brilliant and beautiful. beautiful in their simplicity. Pain tore through his leg as he stood, but he endured, pushing onward, walking the dusty path, leaving a trail of blood flowing behind him. That's probably the longest story out of all of them. They have a whole entire background story to this. Like, with the whole entity and everything.
Is it like a book?
No. Okay. What do you want me to do now? Do you want me to like? I don't wanna be a good baby. Oh, do you wanna go to sleep real quick? Macro. I'm gonna do my trig in class. I'd really like to study from my history a little bit before I go to sleep. Probably also study from history. Oh, what are you studying for? My test tomorrow? Oh.
Well, yeah, but our tests are way less of a big deal than your graduates. Ours is
I wish. I really wish.
They're like, it's like a small percentage of chance of there being an essay. But even if there is an essay, it's like one question. They are answering.
Hey, do you wanna go fight the wither? What do you mean your aquarium's kind of dead? Okay, I don't think so. You know sea pickles grow. You know sea pickles grow, right? So you could break one and place another one in a different spot. So if you place one, it'll grow to four. Then you could break that, get four sea pickles out of it. There's no more fish than that. Well, I mean, there's sunfish.
What happened? I don't know if pufferfish hurt you.
Lainey?
Yeah.
about it for a second. Well, there's a few things I like to try and be as realistic as possible. Is it cool if I play another round of Dota 2? Why not? Why? Well, I love you more, so... I actually do, though. I think it's gonna be hilarious the day you actually figure out, like, that I truly do love you. What? like the name of the Is that like their actual name?
Yeah, like you scroll over, it says Bucket of Sky Gray.
That's cool. Can I see it? Give the bucket of water. Give the bucket. If you go to an anvil and you name the bucket of fish water thing, yeah, then it names the fish.
What?
So what do you want to name it?
I have no idea.
Just Sky Gray Glitter?
Let's name it Sky.
Sky? Oh, whoa, he's actually really cool looking. Whoa. I should probably get out of here before I drown.
There you go. There you are, little Sky. I didn't name him.
It actually didn't?
No.
I'm sorry.
No.
Okay, grab him back. We'll rename this name tag to the Sky. Oh crap, it's a new map!
They made a new map, dude.
Yeah. I haven't seen it. Yo, this is sick!
It still hasn't even, on my screen, you have
Yeah, right? tell because of the thing. Just because it was. Actually go to sleep, my black big dumb.